is back on the gridiron. Now it's time for the Kibbie Dome, Idaho, Colorado State.
Whoa!
Kibbie, baby!
A packed Kibbie Dome in Moscow, Idaho is ready for an Old West matchup. The Vandals of Idaho from the WAC versus the Mountain West Colorado State Rams on ESPNU. Welcome you to College Football Primetime on ESPNU, presented by Citi at the Kibbie Dome in Moscow, Idaho, as the Colorado State Rams take on the Vandals of the University of Idaho. I'm Carter Blackburn with former Ohio State Buckeye John Berger. Just a couple of years ago, these teams' fans didn't have much to cheer about. Colorado State went through a 13-game losing streak. Idaho went through an 11-game losing streak. Thankfully for both of these groups of fans, 2009, very different story.
Yeah, very different story. New coaches, new teams. And when you look at both these football teams, I think it really boils down to coaching. When you look at Steve Fairchild, comes in his first year to Colorado State, gets him to a bowl game, wins that bowl game. Right now, they're 3-1. Their only loss to BYU in a conference game. They feel like they gave it away with some early turnovers in the first half of that ball game. You know that Rob Akey for Idaho, 3-1. Their only loss is to Washington, as in the Huskies, as in the team that beat USC. So they're playing with a lot of confidence right now. We're going to see a very aggressive style play out of Idaho.
Well, it's been about 15 years since the fans of the Idaho Vandals have had a 3-1 football team to cheer for. Onto the Kibbie Dome field they come. What's the Kibbie Dome? What's the battle axe? What are the Vandals? We'll answer all those questions. We'll be kicking off next. They've packed the Kibbie Dome in Moscow, Idaho, late on a Saturday night for Colorado State versus Idaho. The Vandals had just 3 wins in the previous 2 seasons, but in 2009, already a 3-1 start. Their first in 15 years. So, John, what do you think the Vandals have to do to get to 4-1 against this Colorado State team?
Well, I think for Idaho, obviously you got to come out, you got to get some traction early in this ball game. There's a big crowd, a lot of passion, a lot of energy in this stadium right now, and the players want to feed off that. They need to get that short passing game going, and they need to win the intangibles: field position, turnover, special teams. And for Colorado, it's important that they start fast. Last week against BYU, they felt like they gave that ball game away in the first half. They had 2 interceptions, a missed field goal, and a blocked punt. Before you could even get your remote, it was 21-0. So they want to get out. They want to start fast. And the other thing is, on third down, they've got to find a way to get off the football field. That's where BYU killed them last week.
That's why Steve Fairchild said, when you asked him earlier this week, where's your football team right now? He says, I don't know where we're at, because we looked great in those first 3 wins, including a win at Boulder against Colorado. And then the Rams just come out so flat, losing that game a week ago at BYU.
Yeah, and he talked a little bit about that. Anytime that you start a quarterback, Grant Stucker, for the most part, this is his 4th game starting. Although he's a senior, he doesn't have that much playing experience. They got off to a bad start, and it's really hard to tell where this Colorado State team is at right now. But the good thing is, Carter, they have a giant, huge, veteran offensive line. They're going to run behind that offensive line, try to get some traction early in this ball game.
Rob Akey, longtime assistant at Washington State, first head coaching job now in his 3rd season, going on the road to New Mexico State and winning in the opener in 2009. Was a big victory for this football team and for this program.
Yeah, it was. But Rob Akey, when you look at him as a coach, one of the things that he brings is a whole new level of awareness, an intensity, an energy, an enthusiasm that they haven't seen around this Idaho program for a long time. And the other thing, Carter, is he brings a tradition of winning. When he was at Washington State, he was part of 3 10-win seasons, 3 top 10 finishes, a Rose Bowl. He has set expectations high, and so far his players have responded to that.
Even though these programs in the West, they haven't played a whole lot, just 5 times. This is just the 6th ever meeting. This is Colorado State's first trip to Idaho since 1973. First meeting overall since 1992. Of course, Idaho's only been a Division I-A program for about a decade. At the Kibbie Dome, named after William Kibbie, who was only briefly an Idaho student, went on to a career in construction in Utah. But the fans who suffered through three wins in only three seasons, excited to have a football team 3-1 taking on a Colorado State team that's 3-1. And well, been a long time since they've had a game like this in the Kibbie Dome. Colorado State will receive the opening kick. Trey Farquhar kicks it off from the end zone. This is Deion Moore, who's averaging over 20 yards in return. And he picks up 27 yards on this return. Good starting field position for the Colorado State Rams. An offense averaging 26 points per game. It is based on the run mostly, but Grant Stucker can also throw it deep.
Yeah, there's no doubt. Grant Stucker, 31 out of 51, 372 yards last week against BYU. They don't want him to have to throw the football that much to win a ball game. That was a function of them getting down early. They want to get in behind this big offensive line, establish the run game, and then take some selective shots downfield to try to create some big plays.
Bozier on first down, not much doing. Jeremy Jones comes up to help out on the stop. Take a look at our impact players for the Colorado State Rams.
Yeah, it all starts with John Mosier, the running back, the junior out of Miami, 211 pounds. One of the things that I like about him when you watch him on field, he gets upfield fast. The other thing is he's a complete back. He catches the football out of the backfield. He's assignment sound and protects his quarterback. Deion Morton and Rayshon Greer can get downfield. And Elijah Blue Smith leads the team in interceptions. Very athletic defensive back.
Second down and 7 to the air. It's incomplete. Bad throw intended for Mosier. Starting lineups will be scrolling across the top of the screen as we get set for third down, which is a big key, obviously, in any football game. But when Idaho has been successful, they've been getting off the field on third down.
Yeah, not only that, but that's been an area that Colorado State has struggled so far to only 29%. We'll see what they can dial up here. Greg Peterson, the offensive coordinator for the Rams.
Third and 7. Stucker, time to throw, heaves it long. Just over the outstretched arms of Deion Morton. A 3-and-out on the opening possession for Colorado State.
It's great protection up front. Great blocking, and Grant Stucker just gives his wide receiver Deion Morton time to get down to the seam. There was a blown coverage in the secondary for Idaho, and they dodged a bullet right there.
One of John's points for Colorado State was to get off to a fast start, and you didn't want to see Pete Kondodiakis out there to punt if you're a Colorado State Rams fan. Shiloh Keo lets it bounce, and it takes a terrible bounce for Colorado State, rolling all the way back to the 41. And that's where Idaho will get the football first. Vandals 3-1 with Nathan Enderle, the junior out of North Platte, Nebraska, at quarterback for his third year.
Yeah, third year starting quarterback, very mature, runs the offense well, makes good decisions with the football. 18 to 23 last week, the WAC Offensive Player of the Week. And Steve Axman, the offensive coordinator, has a lot of confidence in this young man. Gives him total freedom at the line of scrimmage.
Vandals coming off a win at Northern Illinois when Enderle threw 3 touchdown passes. Started off with a screen. Maurice Shaw. Fast start for Idaho as we look at the impact players for the Vandals.
Yeah, it starts with DeMondre Woodridge, the running back. Big back, 241 pounds, runs behind his pads, 7-yard average. He's the type of back you can give him the ball 20 balls a game, and he will finish. Max Komar and Shiloh Keo, Steve Senecal at the linebacker position. Very active linebacker. He anchors the defense.
Second and short. Hand off to Woodridge, who gets shoved back. No gain. McCarty actually on the carry. Starting lineups for Idaho are at the top of your screen. And already a third down and short for the Idaho offense against a Rams defense. Giving up nearly 26 points a game. Woodridge is the tailback. Shaw short drop. Enderle completes it for a first down to Eric Greenwood.
Carter, anytime on third down, third in a manageable distance. Eric Greenwood, number one, goes 6-6. There's a big time mismatch between between Eric Greenwood and the defensive backs for Colorado State. Keep an eye on that, because Nathan Enderle, he will take that matchup every time and continue to move the chains, picking up a big first down here early in the ball game.
First and 10 from the 40. Bjorvik goes in motion. Idaho playing without starting tight end Daniel Hardy. Play fake to McCarty. Enderle throws it long. It is batted and incomplete. Elijah Blue Smith with the coverage.
Little play action misdirection, and Nate Enderle rolls to his left side. He just allows his wide receiver to clear, but look at the closing speed by Elijah Blue Smith, the Colorado State defensive back. He's beat early, and that route structure accelerates through that and bats that football away. Heads up play by Elijah Blue Smith.
Pressure coming on second down. Screen to Komar. Max Komar slips as he tries to turn the corner, only picks up a couple. A lot of familiarity between the offensive coordinator for Idaho, Steve Axman, defensive coordinator for Larry Kerr. They coached together at Stanford. Kerr actually worked for Steve Axman when Axman was the head coach in Northern Arizona. So a lot of gamesmanship on this side of the football. Third down and 7. If there was contact, then that is obviously offsides, and apparently there was. Guy Miller made contact. Otherwise,
offside. Number 66 of the defense, 5-yard penalty. Third down.
Yeah, costly penalty by Guy Miller. Jumping offsides, taking a 3rd and 7, which is an obvious passing situation. Now it's 3rd and 2. You have the opportunity, a lot more freedom in what you can call here, especially with DeMondre Woolridge in the backfield at 241 pounds.
Third down and short. Enderle trying to draw him offsides again. Play clock ticking under 5. Enderle hands off. Deontay Jackson cuts it back and gets a first down before Nick Offenier makes the tackle.
Deontay Jackson, we're going to see 3 running backs from Idaho early in this ball game. Good blocking up front. Deontay Jackson, the junior, out of Arkansas, gives him a little bit of speed, a little bit of wiggle, which is a little bit different than DeMondre Woolridge, the other running back. We're going to see 3 of them, including Princeton McCarty as well. It's a good 1-2-3 and punch for Idaho.
Jackson takes a direct snap and then flips it back to Enderle for the flea flicker. Pass is complete. Pickup of 9. Creative play calling early on. Marcel Posey makes the grab.
I love the play calling by offensive coordinator Steve Axman on this drive. He continues to mix it up. He recognizes the strength of the Colorado State defense is right up the gut. Right now, he's just trying to spread out Colorado State, get different playmakers in space, and so far they're having success with it on this drive.
Second down and 2. Rams show pressure up the middle. Enderle, quick draw, over the middle, caught. Komar inside the 10, wrestled down inside the 5.
Carter, Steve Axman, the offensive coordinator, if you look at their game plan, they're just trying to get their playmakers isolated on the linebackers, and right there, number 22, Max Komar, comes out of the slot, full speed, against Chris Gibson, and that's a matchup that they're going to take every time. If they can get their wide receivers, especially Komar, isolated in those linebackers, they're going to have a lot of success tonight.
Gibson's a redshirt freshman making his first career start. Enderle under center, first and goal for Idaho. Play fake, Enderle, pressure, gets rid of it, throws, it's intercepted in the end zone. Nick Offenier picks it off. Nick Oppenheer gets a big block at the 30. Oppenheer, another block, still inbounds, and now he's finally shoved out near the 40. What a game-changing INT for Nick Oppenheer. The former walk-on out of Littleton, Colorado, picks it off from the end zone and runs it back nearly 60 yards.
What a huge sequence of events. Idaho has a successful drive. They get down inside the red zone. Nate Enderle just makes an errant throw. He's trying to get the ball over to the tight end, but Nick Oppenheer, number 11, the quarterback for Colorado State, intercepts the pass, takes it back nearly 60 yards. Now he sets up the Rams with great field position here for their second drive.
Oppenheer had one last week at BYU and now has one this week at Idaho. Rams give it to John Mosier on first down, pick up a three.
Greg Peterson, the offensive coordinator, I spoke with him before the game. They're going to continue to try to pound John Mosier. We're also going to see Leonard Mason as well. And don't be surprised if you see a true freshman, Lou Greenwood, out of Conroe, Texas. They're going to try to get all those backs involved in the football game. And each one of them very similar. They all give you about 4 yards of carry, which is exactly what Greg Peterson wants out of this offensive run game.
High backfield on second down. Mosier goes out as a receiver. Stucker heaves it long to the end zone. It's incomplete. Into double coverage. Pass intended for Rayshon Greer. That's music to Colorado State fans' ears because he was benched for most of the BYU game after a couple of early drops.
Yeah, a couple of early drops. And Greg Peterson, this is typically what you will see Colorado State do when they get down near the red zone and the appropriate down and distance. That was a second down and 7. It was a throwaway play. And they're just going to try to take their shots downfield. They feel like Deion Morton and Rayshon Greer are both big playmakers that can get vertical. Now it sets up a third and long here. Don't be surprised if you see them go to their tight end or their running backs out of the backfield, either Mosier or Leonard Mason.
Vandals bring pressure. Stucky throws complete. It's Rayshon Greer who makes the grab. Off the pass from Grant Stucker, picks up a first down and more. And there are the sure hands of Rayshon Greer Colorado State is used to.
Yeah, not only that, Carter, but did you see the protection up front on the last two plays? This offensive line, Steve Fairchild, the head coach, which, by the way, spent many, many years, 8 years in the NFL, thinks he has 4 offensive linemen that will play on Sundays. That is remarkable. Shelly Smith and Tim Walker, the chief bell cows up front, are having a big night tonight already early in the ballgame.
It is the most experienced offensive line anywhere in college football. Play fake. Pass complete. Tyson Leggett. Into the end zone. Touchdown. Jones caught up with him, but not before the plane is broken. Tyson Leggett with his second touchdown of the season, his second in as many weeks.
Tyson Leggett has emerged the last 2 weeks. He had a breakout ball game with 11 catches last week against BYU. They just go with a little play action misdirection scheme back to Leggett. He does a nice job of just being patient, setting up his blocks, and taking it into the end zone.
Bendelon's PAT is good. It's 7-0 Colorado State. So Idaho coughs it up. An interception from Oppenheer. The Rams able to march down, punch it in. A 7-0 start for Colorado State. Primetime is presented by City. City never sleeps. We're in the Palouse area. That's northern Idaho, southeastern Washington, the wheat-growing region here. We're right on the border. If you get out your map and look up Moscow, Idaho, just about 7-8 miles just east of Pullman, Washington, home of Washington State. Quick drive there for Colorado State. Leggett with a touchdown catch after the 42-yard drive. Beautiful time of year to come to Idaho, the Palouse. takes it from near the goal line for Idaho. Bailey still rolling across the 30. So the last time that the Vandals had the football, they drove all the way to the end zone through an interception. Rams turned that into a touchdown. What does the Vandal offense do this time with the football? On first down, a short game for Princeton McCarty for Idaho. I say short game, picks up eight. I think the Vandals would
might take
that.
Exception to that.
Any first down they could get it. Any down they could get it. So call it second down and two. Enderley under center. It's Princeton McCarty, the sophomore from Bakersfield, California, behind him. Give it to McCarty. First down for the Vandals across midfield. And there you see running back number three of the three-headed Vandal running back monster.
Yeah, it's really a luxury for offensive coordinator Steve Axman, and you're going to continue to see him try to spread out Colorado State. They recognize that the strength of that defense is right up the gut. You're going to continue to see him spread them out, and you saw it right there. They're going to continue to attack the edge, and they like the fact that they have three different running backs, all with a little bit different style in Jackson, McCarty, and Woolridge.
First and 10 from near midfield. Enderley to the air, completing to Maurice Shaw. Wrestles out of the tackle from Nick Offenier. Picks up six.
Right now, Idaho is just having a lot of success on first down. And anytime you can have a pickup positive yardage, 4 or 5 yards on first down, that really opens up your playbook and gives you a lot of flexibility. First drive, they march it right down to the two. They make a fatal error in throwing the pick, but they're having a lot of success early in these drives on first down.
Second down and short here. Second and four. It's Woolridge running away from the pressure to get another Idaho first down.
Good blocking up front by Irvin Stevens and Bryce Sinclair at the point of attack. They want to keep Colorado State honest. They want to continue to run the football, have a little bit of balance, and try to use that short passing game to try to create some big plays downfield.
Enderley changing the play on first down and 10. He has wide leverage at the line of scrimmage, the third-year starter. Long drop on first down, pumps one way, looks the other, Tovar can't haul it in.
There was a mix-up in coverage in the secondary for Colorado State, and Max Komar was wide open, went right down the seam, and Elijah Blue Smith and D'Angelo Wilkinson, the defensive backs for Colorado State, there was a mix-up, broken coverage, and Nate Enderley just overthrew him.
7 of 9, 55 yards. And you said it was really about the short passing game moving the chains for Idaho. This is second down and 10, setting up the screen. McCarty hauls it in. Picks up maybe two.
Carter, right now, what's going on offensively for Idaho, when Nate Enderley comes to the line of scrimmage and he thinks Nick Offenier and D'Angelo Wilkinson are in man, he's going to challenge them. And that's something to keep an eye on, because on this drive and the previous drive, when he saw man coverage, obviously they like their ability to get downfield with Greenwood, Preston Davis, and Max Komar. It's interesting the way this is playing out, because I thought they would continue to try to pound the football, but they like that matchup in one-on-one situations.
There's some pad coverage here before third down and 8. So we'll see what Enderley dials up at the line of scrimmage. Long drop, pressure coming, has to get rid of it. It is incomplete. Colorado State wants a grounding flag. Discussion coming. There it is, intentional grounding.
Yeah, Colorado State just dials up the pressure. Number 3, Chris Gibson.
Enderley has lost it down from the spot of the foul. Fourth down.
Enderley recognized that Chris Gibson was on a blitz and just got the ground. That's a costly penalty there with the loss of down, Carter.
Loss of 11 yards on the play because of the intentional grounding. no doubt that Ender Lee was between that tackle box, as it's known.
Yep, second consecutive drive where they got off to a fast start and mistakes just stalled that drive.
First time it was the interception in the end zone. This time it's a punt. Bobby Cowan, freshman from Vancouver, Washington, will punt it away. Deion Morton back to receive for Colorado State. Delay of game, I believe, coming up against Idaho.
Kicking team. 5-yard penalty remains fourth down.
Only time that Idaho attempted a punt last week at Northern Illinois, it was blocked. Cowan, a freshman, is replacing the All-American TJ Conlon. Obviously, indoors in Idaho, a pretty good place to kick. Cowan hits this one right around the 35. Backing Morton up inside the 10. Good punt. Morton bobbles it, comes away with it. But now Morton turns the corner. Deion Morton hits the accelerator across the 40, all the way back to the 48. So once again, the Rams will start with a short field. Last time it was an INT setting up a touchdown. This time the return from Morton. That would be similar to an Idaho alum who named her daughter Bristol. 7-0 Colorado State on Idaho. You're watching ESPNU's College Football Primetime, presented by City.
Yeah, huge punt return, huge special teams play by Deion Morton. You saw the block right there by number 33, Lou Greenwood, the freshman running back out of Conroe that sprung Deion Morton. That's a huge pickup, giving Colorado State great field position here to start their third drive.
41-yard return for Deion Morton. Leonard Mason gets the first down carry, running around the right side. Mason puts his shoulder down, picks up about four before Paul Siniscal brings him down. Mason, first year out of the College of the Desert, had 107 yards in that win at Colorado. What a huge win for Colorado State, their first in Boulder since 86.
Yeah, that was a huge game. In-state rivalry, playing against Colorado with basically a rookie quarterback. Getting out of there with the win gave this team a great deal of confidence going into the rest of their season.
Last year, Billy Ferris was the QB for the Rams. Now it's Grant Stucker, who's also a senior first-year starter. And Stucker goes to the air on second down, complete. There's a missed tackle. Another missed tackle. Helmet comes flying off. As Greenwood picks up the first down with some tough running. Lou Greenwood, the freshman out of Conroe.
Yep. Steve Fairchild, the head coach for Colorado State, talked to him earlier this week, and he said, look, I've got a back and a freshman in this Lou Greenwood kid that I got to get on the football field because he just makes plays in practice. He runs downhill at you. He's only 175 pounds, but I got to tell you, he runs like a back that's, you know, 2 1/4.
Robert C.V., the weak side linebacker, got to know him when he popped his helmet off. First and 10 from the 29. This is Mason picking his way for about five. Log on to Facebook today, search ESPNU, and become a fan. Post your best tailgating photos and comments. We may use them on Inside the Polls Mondays at 6 p.m. on ESPNU HD. Texas Tech Red Raider football players are not eligible. Mosier lined up for the direct snap in the Wildcat for the Colorado State Rams. Paunga leading the way for Mosier. Tripped up near the first down marker.
Right now, early in the ball game, the offensive line for Colorado State just starting to assert itself. Last two plays gone to the right side behind Adrian Martinez and Mark Starr. Shelly Smith and Tim Walter all playing well up front. They're starting to lean on that smaller defensive line for Idaho, having a lot of success.
Third down and about half a yard. Stucker play fake. They'll run it back incomplete. Had it dialed up, but the pass incomplete intended for the gap.
Had the right play call there. Stucker just delivers a ball just right over Leggett's head. They try to go to that same play we saw on the first drive, a play action misdirection to Leggett. He just overthrows him, setting up a fourth short. It appears they're going to dial it up. Greg Peterson, the offensive coordinator, going for it early here in this ball game.
Last week, the kicker Ben DeLine missed a 31-yarder versus BYU. So the head coach says fourth and short from the 20, we're going for it. Stucker gives to Mosier. Leaning for the first down, running behind the left tackle, Cole Pemberton.
Good push up front, and John Mosier, they're going to have him in the backfield on all short yarded situations. And the reason that it is, the reason that is because Steve Fairchild told us this week, I like the way this guy gets north and south, and he does it fast.
Mason in a tailback for first and 10 after the fourth down conversion. Fights the tight end in motion. Stugner handing off to Mason. Kicking his way through the defense, rolling through. Missed tackles by the Vandals. Jeremy Jones finally brings him down. But a lot of missed tackles on this drive.
Yeah, right now Colorado State in the play calling just has Idaho back on their heels. They go with the stretch play to Leonard Mason. Good blocking up front. He fights his way through there. But just as an observation, Carter, this is a high volume offense. That's the term that Fairchild puts to it. Let me interpret that. The playbook is huge. They threw a lot of formations, a lot of sets at the Idaho defense. Right now, they just have them back on their heels.
Second and short, give it to Mason again. Picks up the first down inside the five, so it's first and goal for the Rams coming up.
Leonard Mason, you can see how patient he is as a running back, and they're creating so many lanes up front. Shelly Smith and Tim Walter are just having a field day out there right now on this drive, just blowing open holes, not only for Mosier, but you saw Mason right there. We're going to continue to see all three backs, including Lou Greenwood.
First and goal from the three. Mason gets the handoff, nothing doing on first down. Michael Cosgrove with Sataraka combining on the stop. Second down and goal. Play fake. Stucker rolling, throwing. Heights makes the grab for the touchdown. A 2-touchdown lead for Colorado State.
Well executed play by the Rams. Again, they go with the play action, the misdirection. It freezes the linebackers, and Stucker basically has two options right there. Pites, which he delivers the football to, but Deion Morton was also wide open on the backside. Right now, Colorado State just has the Idaho defense back on their heels, and they're basically just guessing what's coming next. Great execution by the Rams.
You know, it was just 2 years ago Colorado State was enduring a 13-game losing streak, but in Steve Fairchild's first 2 years, they've won 6 of 7 games coming into this one, including the New Mexico Bowl win over Fresno State, who was a WAC team. So the Rams weren't on the radar there for a while, but
Steve Fairchild has done a remarkable job as a first-year head coach, or coming in his second year, but last year as a first-year head coach, getting them to a bowl game. Because covering Colorado State, when you looked at that program, it was a program on decline in terms of their energy, their enthusiasm, their body language on the field, their facilities. And in less than 2 years, Steve Fairchild has basically gone a long way in getting all of that turned around. And you can tell by the way that they play, the way they carry themselves, and the physical nature of the way they're playing tonight. He has made a big impact early in his tenure.
And, of course, he gives a lot of credit to Sonny Lubick, who was the longtime coach of Colorado State. The field was named after Sonny Lubick. Mark Lubick is on Steve Fairchild's staff. Steve Fairchild coached with Sonny Lubick. So a lot of respect given to the tradition of success that Colorado State built up under Sonny Lubick.
The other thing, Carter, is Colorado State, in terms of their future, they put 19 kids that haven't played in a Division I game. This was their debut in 2009. So not only are they getting production right now, but they've got a backfill of a lot of young players that are going to be very, very good.
Matthew Harvey returns it out to the 33. Idaho football when we return. In Moscow, Idaho, it's 14-0 Colorado State on Vandals. Let's check in with Lowell, Sports Center U.
Carter, thank you so much. And here is your update on USC. They're absolutely thumping the Cal Golden Bears. Joe McKnight with his second touchdown of the game. And right now, Javon Best, he is struggling. Only 47 yards in this one. Carter, back to you, buddy.
Lowell, you talk about, I mean, a two-week absolute disappearance from the landscape now for Cal. You get waxed by Oregon. This is supposed to be the game where you come out and, you know, get things back on track. Javon Best struggling. The Cal Bears, I mean, obviously playing USC is tough, but that's back-to-back poor performances from Cal.
Not only that, but in my opinion, you look at the national picture, there's three teams that we know something about: Florida, Texas, and Alabama. And anything from spot 4 through 25, I think, is you're tossing the coin right now.
Second down and short coming up for Idaho here as they trail 14-0. I thought it was a big win for Alabama today, going to Kentucky. That doesn't sound like a tough game, but going on the road in the SEC.
And you said that with a straight face. I love that.
With all of the letdowns that had been, you know, popping up around college football, I think it was a pretty good performance. Short gain on second down by DeMondre Woldrich, so that brings up third down. Michael Sisson on the stop. Weak side linebacker for Colorado State, a linebacking core that is very thin for the Rams.
Yeah, very thin, and it's something they've got to continue to recruit to. But I want to go back to where we're at with Idaho right now. Down 14 at home. Colorado State is basically taking this crowd out of the ballgame. All the momentum is on their side. They're up by 14. It's important that Idaho answer right now on this drive and put some points back on the board. Put some points on the board and get some confidence back.
Komar in motion on third down and short. Kowalik gets in the backfield and blows up the third down and short play. Michael Kowalik, the sophomore strong side linebacker, got the jump.
Michael Kowalik, yeah, he recognized that play early and watch him just fill right up into the gap and just bring the ball carrier down. It appears from up here, Carter, he's going to be about half a yard short.
They're bringing the chains out, but I'm telling you right now, it is nowhere close. Let's see if we've been proven correct.
Is that half a yard?
Yeah. Got some problems. The stick was wobbly there a little bit. So fourth down in short coming up. Idaho this year 1 of 3 on fourth down. And I guess Rob Akey thinking, all right, third down, we couldn't pick up a yard.
No, that's not the spot in the game or on the field to take a risk. Right now, they need to get their defense, punt the football, get their defense on the field, make a stop, and just try to get some positive momentum going offensively so they can get this crowd and the emotion back in the ballgame.
Thomas is back for the punt return. Remember, Gordon had a 41-yard return the last time out. Cowan hangs this one high. Fair catch. Called for. There's a flag coming up. That will be kick catch interference on the kicking team. No doubt about that one. Eric Hunter.
Kick catch interference, number 4 of the kicking team. This is a 15-yard penalty. First down, Colorado State.
Let's take a look. John, do you think they make the right call here with catch interference?
Yeah, that would you say he was interfered?
Yeah, I would say he interfered in there, and Eric Hunter, the junior, goes over and he's going to get an earful from Coach Akey. That's, you know, that's just a silly penalty. If you know, you can avoid things like that. Why give Colorado State additional field position here when you had them back up to start this drive?
First down and 10. Stucker, straight drop, flings it to the outside for Morton, who picks up 8. Monday evening, catch 2 college football shows on ESPNU. First at 5 Eastern, Crunch Time will deliver the entire closing moments of all the exciting college football contests from the previous weekend. Then at 6 Eastern, Lowell in the Game, dissect and analyze the new polls inside the polls presented by 76. For more, log on to ESPNU.com. Short field on the last 2 possessions for Colorado State. They turned them into touchdowns. Mason on 2nd down gets the 1st down and gets back into Idaho territory across midfield.
Watch the blocking up front by the offensive line for Colorado State. Leonard Mason is 8 yards into this play before Vandal touches him. Colorado State just having their way up front at the point of attack, just blowing open holes for their running backs, taking advantage of that big-time size mismatch.
Stucker pumps left, looking for a receiver right. He's covered up, so he has to throw it out of bounds.
Trying to set up a screen play there, and Idaho recognized that, the Vandals early in the development of that process, and Stucker did a nice job recognizing that there was nothing there and just throws the football away. They fake it to the left. They're trying to draw the linebackers up, and that was just a busted play, and Stucker just throws the ball away. It was a heads-up play. Just live for another day. 2nd and 10 here, and you still have all the momentum on your side.
Give it to Zach Pongo, the fullback from Lakewood, Colorado, for a couple of yards on 2nd down. So 3rd down coming up. And this is a critical 3rd down. Idaho down by 14. They need to get off the field and get the football back to their offense.
Yep, Idaho, the defense has been on the field. They need to get off of it. It's a critical 3rd and long. And they need to pay attention. Number 45, the tight end, Eric Pites. And pay particular attention because they may take a shot downfield to 31, Deion Morton.
Rams are only 1 of 3 on 3rd down. Vandals blitz. Enderle hit as he throws. Incomplete. The Vandals get the stop they needed. Cosgrove and Siavii bring the pressure.
Yeah, Mark Kreiner, the defensive coordinator for Idaho, brings pressure there on 3rd down. Big time conversion, gets his defense off the football field, but he recognizes that they're not going to get to Grant. They can't just allow him to sit back there and pick this team apart. He brings pressure, they convert, get their defense off the field. Now their offense is going to have some decent field position here after this punt.
Pete Kadodiakis barely gets it off as Idaho was going for the block. Bounces inside the 10 since they were going for the block. It rolls into the end zone for a touchback. Vandals get the football back, trailing by 14.
Idaho struggling offensively, and you'll see number 88, Daniel Hardy, on the sideline. He was their number one wide receiver coming into the ball game with 14 receptions. And right now, they're struggling to try to figure out, how do we get the ball downfield? Max Komar and Eric Greenwood are going to have to step up there because Hardy's not playing tonight.
Play action on 1st down. Enderle throws. It's short for Komar. Komar was open again. This time, Enderle leaves it short. That's twice that they have missed long pass plays.
Yeah, right now, Enderle's just out of sync. And a lot of that just has to do with the pressure that Colorado State is applying in the secondary. They play a 2-deep zone. It's kind of a mush defense on the back end, and there's just nowhere to throw the football. Idaho's first drive, they had success in the short passing game. Play action, misdirection, short passing game. They got to get back to that and get some positive yardage here on this drive.
Enderle just two for his last five passing. Nathan Enderle with a long drop on second down, setting up the drag. Tomar makes the catch over the middle. Back to the short passing game. It produces an Idaho first down.
Yep, and that's exactly what they had success with early in the ball game. Colorado State, at this position of the field, is going to give you that play. Tomar is going to have success getting manned up against the Ram linebackers. Idaho needs to take advantage of that, just methodically work their way down the field. When Colorado State adjusts to that, then they can go for a big play to either Greenwood or Preston Davis.
Before first down, maybe a confusion about the spot. I'm not sure. Longer than 10 yards. First down, pressure coming. Enderle never saw it. Got rid of the football anyway. There were four defenders around Max Komar.
Colorado State just dialing up the pressure from the linebacker possession. Position number 47, Zach Tijan, coming off the edge and applying the pressure. Right now, Idaho's just completely out of sync. Their last two possessions, or last three possessions, one interception and two punts, and their field position hasn't been that bad, their starting field position.
Elijah Blue Smith, the free safety, showed blitz, so Enderle checks. Second down to the air. Komar makes the grab, dragging through the Colorado State zone for a first down near midfield.
Anytime a defense is playing a two-deep zone, you're going to have success in this part of the field, bringing your wide receivers on top of the linebackers in front of the safeties. That's the second big play we've seen Max Komar make on this drive, and they had a lot of success with the same play structure on their first drive early in this ball game.
Four catches for Komar. Now 18 straight games he has with a reception. He is one of just 11 seniors on the roster. Very young Idaho team. Woolridge, another one of those seniors, picks up about four on first down. Rob Akey turned over the roster when he got here 3 years ago. That was after Dennis Erickson was here for just 1 year. So you had three head coaches in 3 years. And Rob Akey basically started from the ground up with players like Nathan Enderle, who's now a junior quarterback. He's been starting for 3 years. So you say, well, how does a team go from three wins in 3 years to a 3-1 start? These guys have played a lot of football. Second down and six. Gibson showing pressure from linebacker. Enderle play fake, throws long. Intended for Greenwood. It's overthrown and incomplete. You're watching ESPNU's College Football Primetime presented by Citi at the Kibbie Dome, the University of Idaho. Carter Blackburn alongside Ohio State Buckeye alumnus John Berger in Moscow, Idaho, staying up late. So late night for Seth, Ryan, Abby, everybody staying up late for this one. Third down, flags before the snap.
Prior to the snap, false start, number 70, offense, 5-yard penalty, third down.
False start for the Vandals, so back them up. Rob Akey, the Weber State grad who played for Mike Price there and then coached with Mike Price in Washington State right down the road. And here's Coach Price now at UTEP. This is third down and 11. Play action. Enderle to Komar, makes the grab, first down. In front of three defenders, Komar makes the catch.
Yeah, Max Komar is going to have a huge day. As long as Colorado State stays back in that two deep zone, they're just going to come on top of the backers in front of the safeties. They go play action. Linebackers react. Enderle finds Komar in front of the safeties. He's going to have a huge day until Colorado State adjusts that. But right now, they don't have to. They have the lead. They're playing well offensively. As Idaho works themselves down to the red zone, look for Colorado State to come up and play man in that situation.
Five receptions, 65 yards now for Komar. Go right back to him on first down on the screen. Gain of nine before Smith shoves him out. Coming into this game, Komar had 13 catches all year. He now has six in the first half.
I was going to say, he may get 13 tonight.
The old helmet tap saying, all right, give me some Gatorade.
Like the play call there. It was a little hurry up, no huddle. They got the ball out to Komar, and they caught Colorado State trying to adjust their defense. And a heads-up play by Elijah Blue Smith getting over there and knocking Komar out of bounds. Otherwise, that would have been a touchdown.
Second and short, Deontay Jackson back in at tailback behind Enderle. Jackson gets it and gets leveled as soon as he touches the football. Guy Miller, the 6'3", 288-pound nose guard, makes the tackle for loss. He had the big fumble recovery to seal a win over Weber State 3 weeks ago, right at the end of the game, last possession.
Yep, not only that, leading the team with sacks, three sacks on the year, and Guy Miller is one of those stories. Larry Kerr, the defensive coordinator, has been very happy. You talked to him earlier this week, very happy with his play up front, stopping the run. When you have run stoppers up front, it makes it a lot easier to play defense on the back end.
Third down and four. Enderle looking to the sideline. It is caught for a touchdown. Greenwood not only hauls it in, he gets it across the goal line. Touchdown, Idaho.
They got the matchup that they wanted. Number one, Eric Greenwood goes 6'6 on the right side. He's manned up against Oppenheer, the corner from Colorado State. It was a great ball placement by Enderle. He goes up, gets the football. Not only that, but Kubiak interfered, or Oppenheer interfered with him. Greenwood did a nice job of focusing, bringing that football in. Now that's a huge score. Gets the crowd back in the ball game, and now Idaho's got a little bit of confidence offensively.
The mild-mannered Rob Akey. Quiet
no,
on the sideline.
No, that don't say that.
Farquhar's point after touchdown is blocked. There is a flag down on the field. This will be a point for Colorado State if this play stands. Again, flag down on the field. So a big call coming up. Akey thinks it's offsides on the defense.
Offside. Defense, half the distance from the goal. The try will be repeated.
That's a big one.
Colorado State gets the block, but they're offside. Elijah Blue Smith elevates and blocks it, but Colorado State's offside. Now Idaho's going to get another shot here to convert.
So a second chance now for Trey Farquhar, true freshman from Redlands, California, on for the PAT. Take two. This time, no offsides, no block, no run back. Just a plain old PAT kick to make it 14-7. Rob Akey's Vandals wake up the Kibbie Dome with a touchdown drive.
Mo Galindo here with your in-game updates. Oklahoma goes down to South Florida. They will return to Norman, Oklahoma with the loss because Miami takes them down by one, 21-20. And Houston trailing UTEP 30-20 despite the fact that Case Keenum has 300 yards. Carter?
Well, how about Ja'Cory Harris after a rough start? Throws three touchdown passes. Jamarcus James, 150 rushing yards. Big win for Miami over OU. I guess it does matter if you have a Heisman Trophy
quarterback or
not. Yeah. Go back to the touchdown here.
They got the matchup that they wanted. Eric Greenwood goes 6-6 against Nick Oppenheimer, the corner. Second big play that Greenwood has had. Great execution by Idaho.
There was pass interference called on that play. Oppenheimer knocking Greenwood out of bounds. Obviously, penalty decline. It was a touchdown. Morton shoved out around the 27. Well, Idaho finally gets a touchdown drive, and the Kibbie Dome has come back to life.
Yep, and Colorado State did a good job of just taking the crowd out of the ball game and had control of it. Then Idaho comes back on a 10-play, 80-yard drive, chewed up 3:48 in clock. Now they got a little bit of bounce in their step, and the crowd is back in this ball game. It's important for them to try to get a three and out here. Only down by seven, but they got Colorado State backed up. They need to get this defense off the field and try to get some more points on the board before halftime.
Grant Stucker, the senior QB, handing off to Leonard Mason. Mason wrapped up by Shiloh Keo, the free safety junior who played only four games last year because of a shoulder injury, received a medical redshirt. Told me earlier this week, playing on this field is my life. So going through that missed year, so what words would you describe? Angry, sad, frustrated, loves being back on the football field. Second down and seven. Give it to Mason again. Trying to stretch it out on the left side behind the tight end Heights. Fighting for a couple. ESPNU kicks two women's college soccer games on Sunday. First at 3 Eastern, LSU takes on Auburn. Then at 5 Eastern, the Missouri Tigers take on the Texas A&M Aggies. Women's college soccer on ESPNU Sunday. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com.
Last two plays, Carter. Mark Kreiner, the defensive coordinator for Idaho, dialed up pressure, expecting Colorado State to run. They've gotten in there and blown out that play. Third and 5 here. Support for Idaho to get off the field.
Quick snap for Colorado State. Mason goes for a ride, but gets the first down. It was Keo who tried to go low on him. Mason helicopters for a first down.
Yeah, Shiloh Keo recognized that play early in its development. Comes up and just upends Mason, but Mason's got enough forward momentum right there to pick up the first down.
Tough way to do it. Keo checks out for first down. Vandals without their defensive leader on the field for first down and 10. Play action. Stucker. Wobbly pass, but it's caught by Rayshon Greer. Breaks the first tackle. Dragged down near the 40 by Brandon Arts.
Watch the arm strength, Carter, from Grant Stucker, the Colorado State quarterback. They're going to go play action. He's going to throw this football basically from the right hash all the way across the football field to Rayshon Greer. He has got a gun for an arm. That is not an easy throw to make.
We talked about those drops by Greer last week that led to two BYU touchdowns in the first quarter when they were interceptions off those two drops. But Greer's a guy over 1,100 yards receiving last season as a junior. First and 10, play action again. Stucker looking long again for Greer again. This one is incomplete. Off of his hands and incomplete.
Grant Stucker placed that ball perfect. Perfect. I mean, he throws a raindrop down to Greer. And Stucker right now is just on fire. He's in sync, and they gave him great protection up front. You can't put a football more on target than what you saw right there. Rayshon Greer is going to go over to the sideline and have a chance to think about that one.
two drops in the first quarter last week versus BYU. He didn't see the field again. You could call that a touchdown drop by Greer. Second and 10, Leonard Mason. Fighting for a few, and speaking of fighting, a little pushing and shoving at the bottom of the pile.
Another big third down for Colorado State. In this part of the field, they like to go to the play action, the misdirection, try to freeze the linebackers to get either their tight end Pites or Deion Morton or Rayshon Greer in space.
Vandals show pressure, flag on the play. False start on the offense.
There was no snap. False start, number 45, offense. 5-yard penalty, third down.
First time that we've seen the crowd come into this ball game. You can tell the student section starting to get a little excitement, a little momentum. Colorado State's having a hard time hearing the signals here in this dome.
Kibbie Dome's a small venue. It's only about 16,000, but it's packed tonight, and because it is a dome, things reverberate. Very difficult for the Rams or any opponent to hear. Third down and 11. Straight drop for Grant Stucker. Looking long again for Greer again. This one is incomplete, batted away. Isaac Butts knocks it away. Pat and Donna Stucker, Grant's parents, trying to encourage the Rams QB. Colorado, who won the job with a great fall camp, beating out John Eastman and Clay Kubiak. Kododiakis gets the punt away. Fair catch called for by Shiloh Keo. So the Idaho defense comes up with a stop. It's still 14-7, the visiting Colorado State Rams. Last time the Vandals had the football, a touchdown drive. Enderle and the Idaho offense will be looking for a tying drive in the final 3:19 of the first half.
A little glendo and a lot of exclamation points coming up on the SportsCenter U halftime report. A BCS buster getting busted up. We'll tell you about Houston. Oklahoma struggling late against Miami. And we will also have the story of LSU going down to the wire. Exclamations!
Lowell, I want to hear about, and I know we'll hear about it at the half, but about Houston apparently in trouble. It's former Washington State head coach Mike Price. First and 10, Enderle. Looking long down the field for Komar, overshoots him by just a couple of yards. Komar was way behind the Ram defense.
They got the look. Idaho that they wanted. They're going to continue to try to isolate number 22 Max Komar downfield on the corner. Nick Oppenheer for Colorado State clearly has him beat, and Enderle just overthrows him. The big time missed opportunity there for Idaho with 3:12 left here in the second quarter.
Enderle sees pressure from the linebackers from Colorado State. They drop in coverage, bring pressure from the other side, and Enderle goes down. Michael Sisson gets to Nathan Enderle.
Colorado State brings pressure from the linebacker position. Michael Sisson breaks free. Not only coming up with seven, interesting, Colorado State heads up, burning a timeout here now that they got Idaho backed up. Third and long. Takes the timeout. They're going to get great field position here for their next possession. All three timeouts, too.
Sisson's a great pass rusher. Freshman All-American a year ago. He had to change positions from the strong side to the weak side. Ricky Brewer, who was supposed to be leader of the Colorado State linebacking corps, suspended for the season. ESPNU kicks two women's college soccer games on Sunday, first at 3 Eastern. LSU taking on Auburn. Then at 5 Eastern, the Missouri Tigers taking on Texas A&M. Women's college soccer on ESPNU Sunday. More information, log on to ESPNU.com. Idaho, the Vandals. And you say, well, why the Vandals? Short answer is there's no real good reason. 1917, the basketball team played such an aggressive style that Harry Lloyd McCarty wrote in the newspaper that they attacked like Vandals. Name just stuck. 1921 officially became the mascot. So here it is, 2009, and they're the Idaho Vandals. Third down and 19, Enderly to the air for Greenwood again, who couldn't run underneath it, incomplete. Rams will get the football back. You know, with the wheat growing around here, you would think maybe the Thrashers, that might work.
I'm just glad you looked at Vandals. To me, when I looked at Vandals, I was thinking like bandit or bank robber, right? What caused you?
Or a guy with a spray paint.
Or a guy with like that looks like a Viking.
Yeah.
Something like that.
That's kind of a Viking looking Vandal in my book. Colorado State Rams will get the football back. Allen. Bad kick after a high snap from Christopher Ramos. So Morton dodges out of a tackle and then dragged down across the 48. This sets up very well for the Rams. Under 3 minutes to go, two timeouts left, and they get the football at the Idaho 48.
Great field position. It's going to give offensive coordinator Greg Peterson a lot of flexibility in what he can do. You're starting in positive territory. You got two timeouts, two big playmakers in Deion Morton and Rayshon Greer. Don't be surprised if Peterson tries to take a shot down the field or perhaps dials up a trick play. Deion Morton can throw the football, was a high school quarterback. Don't be surprised if Greg Peterson dials something like that up, trying to get some points here with all the momentum on their side.
Stucker setting up the screen. Mason makes the grab. Blockers out front. Mason able to pick up 8 on the first down screen play that Greg Peterson calls up.
This is such an integral part of the Ram offense is their screen game. Basically, this is an extension of the run game, Carter. Just trying to attack the edge. And they're one of the best in the business at executing those kind of screen plays.
High backfield on second down and 3. Stucker, pass batted at the line. It drops incomplete. Aaron Laverius got a hand on it.
Stucker has been attacking the left side, and Laverius has had no opportunity, has been stonewalled at the line of scrimmage by Cole Pemberton, does a nice job recognizing there's no way he's going to get there, and just elevates and bats that football away.
Well, you're right. Hardly any pressure on Idaho, or from Idaho. Four wide on third down and 3. Stucker dumps it short, complete for Colorado State first down. It's Lou Greenwood lined up in the slot who makes the catch.
Colorado State goes with four wides, and I like the play selection by Greg Peterson. Spreads out Idaho and just comes back underneath to Lou Greenwood. But you can tell Greg as a freshman getting in there and getting some playing time. How bright of a future do you think he has in Fort Collins?
And Greenwood lined up as a receiver a couple of times, not just in the backfield. They're using him as a slot receiver. Out of the eye on first and 10. Stucker heaves it long to the end zone. It is caught for a touchdown. Deion Morton makes the grab. third touchdown catch of the year for the senior from Riverside, California. There is a flag down in the end zone.
After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct number 18 of the offense. This 15-yard penalty will be enforced on the succeeding kickoff.
It's on the QB, Stucker.
Yeah, it's on the QB, and this is about the fifth time we've seen that call in college football today. I guess they're trying to take the excitement out of doing a little celebrating, but this is the third time we've seen this play.
The PAT is blocked. Ball is still loose. That was the touchdown play. The PAT was blocked. And so it's 20-7. Here's the PAT block.
Idaho just coming off the edge, and the line, the kicker is just late getting that ball off. Ricardo, I want to go back to the play selection by Greg Peterson, the offensive coordinator for Colorado State. Deion Morton, eighth all time. Let's follow it up. When you look at his success on the field for Colorado State, what a weapon, having the ability to go downfield not only to Deion Morton, but Rayshon Greer, and now Tyson Leggett. Greg Peterson's got a lot of weapons at his disposal. And if you look at that touchdown play, Grant Stucker let that ball go loose from the right hash, coming all the way deep to the left end of the end zone. You don't see that play. You don't see that kind of arm strength most of the time in Division I football. Grant Stucker has got a gun for an arm.
We asked Greg Peterson earlier this week, when do you like to take those shots? That's a big part of the Colorado State offense. Run the football, then take a shot. He said anywhere, any field position, any time. We are not limited by down and distance. And third down and three, your opponent's territory, go four wide and chunk it deep. That's
yep.
Greg Peterson, the coach on the phone in the box.
Yep, let it rip and turn it loose, and that's his philosophy. And, you know, Peterson spent 12 years at K-State under Bill Snyder. So he learned a lot, and a lot of his philosophies come from that experience. And for those of you not familiar with Bill Snyder and K-State, Bill Snyder orchestrated what's arguably, you know, the greatest turnaround of a college football program in the history of the game. A lot of great coaches have gone through there, including Bob Stoops, head coach at OU, and Mike Stoops, head coach at Arizona, Mark Mangino, the head guy at Kansas.
And of course, Bill Snyder's back in Manhattan, Kansas, as head coach, second stint with K-State this year. Three touchdown passes in the first half for Grant Stucker, and Colorado State has a 20-7 lead. The Rams have won six out of their last seven games. Short kick, bobbled near the 20. Short kick because of the 15-yard penalty on the QB, Stucker. Jeremy Jones returns it to near midfield for Idaho, so the Vandals will get a crack. Minute 25 left. Idaho has all three timeouts. And they'll actually spot this ball across midfield at the 47 of Colorado State.
Yeah, that's what Idaho needed, a big play on special teams to give them a spark. You have all three timeouts, great field position, down 20-7. It's important that they methodically work their way down the field, smart clock management, and get some points on the board here before the end of the first half.
Play action. Andrew Lee completes to Eric Greenwood. Dancing down the sideline for a first down.
Two guys to keep an eye on, Carter, for Idaho. Eric Greenwood, number one, you saw him right there, creates a lot of mismatches at 6'6". And Max Komar, number 22, coming out of the slot with Colorado State playing that mush two-deep zone. Nate Enderle is going to throw underneath of that all night if he has the opportunity to throw. With three timeouts left, we got a great opportunity here to try to punch one in.
Block almost isn't even a factor at the 35, three timeouts, a minute 18. first down. Enderle is going to tuck it and slide to pick up about seven. Timeout, Idaho. Rob Akey ran nearly to the center to grab the football away to get that timeout call. You think Rob Akey brings some intensity to Vandal football?
Yep, no, there's no doubt. He ran about 30 yards to get that timeout call and wanted to make sure that the official was real clear on what he wanted.
Colorado State's done a good job of getting pressure, at least, on Nathan Enderle.
Yeah, Colorado State defensively, right here, this is just a bad throw. Colorado State gets pressure, but Enderle just throws the interception. But they've had success all day coming from the linebacker position. He's been under duress. And right now, Colorado State just playing more physical on the defensive side of the ball.
Well, we'll see if the Rams can bring some more pressure here on second down. Second and four out of the Idaho timeout. Enderle over the middle. Batted, incomplete, nearly picked. Intended for Komar.
Komar was isolated with Elijah Blue Smith, number 22. Enderle just recognizes that early in the route structure. Elijah Blue Smith just jumps that, bats that football away. That's not the guy, Carter, that you want to attack on Colorado State's defense. In a one-on-one situation, Elijah Blue Smith is going to win that more times than not.
Rams will take a timeout prior to third down and six. Rob Akey, third-year head coach at Idaho, did some interesting things with his team in the offseason. Everybody approaches it differently. He split his team into teams of their own and then had all of those off-season workout things count towards wins and losses.
The mat drills.
The mat drills, exactly. So the winner of that group was Deontay Jackson, the junior running back. His group won what they termed the BCS championship. So as a reward, that BCS bowl-winning team then got to go to Coach Akey's house and he grilled steaks for him. I think Coach Akey's got a little pride in his steak grilling. He mentioned that he also grilled steaks for the entire team at their first fall workout.
Yeah, Coach Akey, he's trying to bring a different mindset and a different attitude to Idaho football. When you consider he was their fourth head coach in 5 years, a lot of those kids have been sitting there in the meeting room, seeing guys coming through the meeting rooms. And let's just be honest, as a player, you're looking at that over a period of time saying, okay, the next guy's going to be here in another 6 months. So he's trying to bring some stability.
Third and four, pass batted incomplete. Intended for Greenwood. Physical coverage from Thomas and Sisson, but they knock it away from Greenwood and no flag.
They're trying to get the ball to Greenwood, 6-6 at the mismatch, and Colorado State just arrives at the football maybe a little bit early. I think that's good coverage. Gerard Thomas gets his hand in there and bats the football away, setting up a 47-yard field goal attempt.
Officially, they'll call it 46, which would be Farquhar's career long. Kick is up. And the kick is good. It's a new career long for the freshman, Trey Farquhar, who is now 8 of 11 kicking. Rob Akey says, even though my freshman missed a couple of kicks versus San Diego State, I have no problem running him out there with the game on the line. Well, this is not game on the line territory, but he does run him out there to test his career long.
Yep, he's got a leg, and I was watching him in warm-ups. He's clearly got, you know, 50-yard range. But more importantly, Carter, it's the opportunity for Idaho to get back on track and at least get some points on the board here in the first half to go into halftime feeling good about yourself. This is a game that clearly could be tied right now had it not been for the interception and a couple of really silly penalties.
And some missed deep ball opportunities. Well, Mr. Berger, the former kicker, you had it eyeballed precisely correctly. A 47 yarder. That is exactly what it goes down as. 47 yarder. That's a new career long. Say career long. This is only his fifth collegiate game.
I was going to say, he hadn't been here that long.
But it is a 47 yarder to make it 20-10. Still two timeouts left here for Idaho, so if you can come up with a quick stop, Farquhar may have another crack at it. Here he is to kick off. Morton fields it at the four. Dion Morton dragged down near the 26. Colorado State a touchdown the last time they were on the field. Three touchdown passes in the first half for Grant Stucker. He had only six in the previous four games. This is definitely a ground-based attack for Colorado State. But obviously, Stucker can hang it up there.
Yeah, he's got a great arm, and we've seen him throw from the right hash all the way back to the left side twice tonight. And you can just see him gaining confidence as a quarterback.
Out of the shotgun on first down, setting up the screen. Haunga makes the grab. He is dropped as soon as he gets the football from the sophomore linebacker, Treshawn Robinson. He started as a true freshman last year until a knee injury at Fresno State cost him the rest of the year, but he could be a star for the Vandals in the middle. Second and 11, Stucker to the air again. Complete. Morton hauls it in. They will say incomplete. Ball hit the turf. Morton pleading his case to the line judge, but pass is incomplete.
It's hard to get a read on that. Deion Morton came across all the way on the backside, and it looked like he secured the football, but no, it did hit, it hit the ground. It was a great call by the official to see that real time.
Steve Fairchild asking if it will be reviewed. But the play clock is running now for Colorado State. They may be forced to take the last time out. And they will. How about Steve Fairchild arguing with the official while keeping an eye on the play clock, yeah, knowing that he had one timeout left? I think he got that timeout call with 1 second on the play clock.
Ruling on the previous play, which was ruled on the field as an incomplete pass.
So as an incomplete pass, there has to be indisputable evidence that he secured the football. And looking at that real time, we'll try to get a decent look at it here, but looking at it real time, it looked like he bobbled the football and it hit the ground. Can't really tell from that angle, but from right here, Carter, it looks like right there the football hits the ground. And for them to overturn, because it was ruled an incomplete pass, there has to be indisputable video evidence to overturn it. I don't see anything there. I think it'll stick. It'll be an incomplete pass. It'll be third and long for Colorado State.
And that's the only challenge that Colorado State has.
Yep.
Which different coaches have different philosophies about when to challenge. Obviously, Fairchild thinks that he needed that one there. Still a chance to score. And here comes the call. Terry Layton.
The ruling on the field is confirmed, incomplete pass, fourth down. Colorado State will be charged with their final timeout of the half.
And when the referee says confirmed, that means that the video evidence supports the call on the field. Sometimes they'll say the ruling on the field stands, which just means the no conclusive video evidence.
Yeah, confirmed just means we got it right. Play ball.
Third down and 11. If Idaho can get a stop on third down, they may have time to score before the end of the half. Fullback Mosier takes it for a gain of only two. Akey immediately calls a timeout. 13 seconds left in the half.
Timeout, Idaho, their second of the half.
One timeout remaining now for Idaho, none for Colorado State. Fairchild, who was a quarterback for Colorado State from 78 to 79. He actually played for Mike Martz at Mesa Community College prior to Colorado State, so that helps you figure out where the dots are connected in the NFL. Offensive coordinator at St. Louis following Mike Martz. When Martz was head coach there, offensive coordinator with the Buffalo Bills as well. Said he really hadn't thought about coming back to Colorado State until Sonny Lubick retired as head coach. And in a conversation with Sonny Lubick, it's kind of when Steve Fairchild said, well, you know, I've always wanted to be a head coach. This may be the time and the place. Going back to the alma mater, help try and get things squared away in Fort Collins. Kadodiakis' punt will finally rest near the 33. And I believe there is 1 second left on the clock. So there will be one play left for Idaho to heave it deep. We've actually seen the Vandals miss a couple of long ball opportunities. One overthrown, one underthrown.
Yeah, for Idaho, the mismatch that they've had success with was Max Komar coming over the middle, but Eric Greenwood, number one, just creates such a mismatch going at 6'6". See if they can try to work him down the field, maybe get a tip.
Last play of the half will be a sack. Zach Tejan gets to Nathan Enderle. That is the end of the half. It is a 20-10 lead for the visiting Colorado State Rams on Idaho at the half. Colorado State on Idaho at the half. Welcome you back to ESPNU's College Football Primetime presented by Citi at the Kibbie Dome on the campus of the University of Idaho in Moscow. It's 20-10 Colorado State on Idaho. Three touchdown passes in the first half for Colorado State QB Grant Stucker. The first a 20-yard pass to Tyson Leggett. And then on the last play of the first quarter, it's the tight end Eric Pites with a touchdown grab.
Yeah, I thought it was a great first half for offensive coordinator Greg Peterson. They really kept Idaho back on their heels, then opened up the downfield big play to Deion Morton there. And then Idaho battles back, and they get the matchup they want. Eric Greenwood on Kubiak, they execute for a touchdown. Close game. Really, the difference is that pick that Enderle threw early in the ball game. Inside the red zone, fairly even ball game. Colorado State leading, obviously, with the pass yards. But look at the pass yards by Idaho, which surprises me a little bit. And again, the key there was the turnover, the early interception by Enderle inside the red zone. Colorado State took it back on a 60-yard return, executed on that drive, and that's the difference in the ball game right now.
You crunch those rushing numbers, you come up with 4.5 yards a carry for Colorado State, 1.4 for Idaho. A big reason why it's a 10-point lead for Colorado State. Idaho will get the football to begin the second half. Bobble by Harvey. He recovers, returns it to the 28, where he is level. So, John, here's what you pointed to before the ball game between the Rams and the Vandals.
Yeah, I thought Colorado State did exactly what they wanted to do. They wanted to come out early and start fast. They got down early last week against BYU. Spent the whole day trying to dig out. And then on third down defense, Idaho was converting. They got to pick that up a little bit. For Idaho, the short passing game, they've executed well with 9 completions under 10 yards. And then we talked about the intangibles. Idaho needed to win that battle. Field position, turnover, special teams. They've had good field position all night. But again, that one key pick early in the ball game is really the difference at this point.
First and 10 for Nathan Enderle, the junior Idaho QB. On the quick slant, pass is caught by Princeton McCarty on the first play of the third quarter. Along with former Ohio State Buckeye John Berger, I'm Carter Blackburn, our entire ESPNU crew from Moscow, Idaho, Kibbie Dome. First time in 15 years that Idaho has had a 3-1 football team. They're down by 10 early in the third. To the air again on second down. Comar makes the grab. Missed tackle by Gerard Thomas, so Comar able to pick up a first down.
Idaho coming out here in the second half in a no-huddle spread attack, trying to create some rhythm and some pace to that offense. Max Comar is having a career day. They want to continue to go to that short passing game, methodically work their way down the field. Because Colorado State is playing a two-deep zone, a mush defense. Take what the defense gives you, try to get into the red zone and execute for touchdowns.
Comar now has 7 catches in the game. From the 41, first and 10. Enderle over middle, pass tipped and incomplete. Intended for the tight end Bjorvik, who is playing because Daniel Hardy is injured, rib injury.
Bjorvik, the tight end, is just going to settle right in front of the linebackers for Colorado State. And James Skelton just does a good job just jumping that route and batting that football away, setting up a second and 10 here.
All pass plays so far in the third quarter for Idaho.
Yeah, Idaho's just trying to create a little bit of rhythm, get in the groove, try to get some decent field position so they can take a shot downfield to either Comar or Greenwood.
Enderle fakes a handoff, rolling right, throwing, complete to Comar. The underneath route, can Comar slips through to the 45.
Yeah, another conversion for Comar. This is the formula. Right now, Colorado State is just not adjusted to that play. They are willing to give up the underneath route, and as long as they're willing to do that, Enderle does a nice job just delivering that football. That's an easy pitch and catch, and Comar is on pace to have a career night here for the Vandals.
8 catches, 97 yards for Comar. Enderle now wants to take a shot to Greenwood. He holds it in. Touchdown, Vandals. What an opening statement for the second half.
They got the matchup that they wanted. Eric Greenwood goes 6'6". D'Angelo Wilkinson, the defensive back for Colorado State, is 5'10". Enderle throws a nice ball, nice raindrop, places it right there. And Greenwood takes it into the end zone. That's a huge statement. Now the crowd is back in the ballgame. That's exactly what Idaho needed here on their first possession of the second half.
It is the first career touchdown grab for the junior from Edmonds, Washington, Eric Greenwood. 99 yards receiving on the day, none bigger than this. Vandals are back in it. Vandal fans excited again. Touchdown Enderle to Greenwood. Idaho appears to have found a matchup they like.
Yep, they love it. And Larry Kerr, the defensive coordinator for Colorado State, is going to have to adjust to that. They're playing a two-deep zone, mush defense on the back end. And right now, Max Comar, number 22, and Eric Greenwood, the 6'6 wide receiver for Idaho, they're just going to continue to go back to that until Colorado State adjusts to it.
First career touchdown grab for Greenwood. Enderle now 7 touchdown passes on the year against only 1 INT. Marquardt's kickoff. Returned by Mosier to the 23. Max Comar, 8 receptions, 96 yards in the game. Greenwood over 100 receiving yards in the game as well.
Max having a little fun there on the sideline. Considering he came into the ballgame with 13 receptions,
right.
He's got 8 already.
Right.
Unbelievable performance by Comar.
And remember, Idaho is playing without one of their big offensive weapons, Daniel Hardy, the 6'4", H-back, tight end, wide receiver, hybrid position player who had 14 catches to lead all Vandals coming into this game. So Comar and Greenwood doing a good job of picking up that drop off in the passing game.
Yeah, very surprised that Colorado State has yet to adjust to that defensively. In fact, if you look at their linebackers, Chris Gibson and Michael Sisson,
they're about 3 yards off the line of scrimmage. They're playing very tight to the line of scrimmage. It'll be interesting to see if they start dropping them into coverage to try to eliminate that route to Komar, because Komar is killing them right now on third down.
There had to have been a penalty on that play. I never saw a flag or got an explanation, but there's a re-kick. It looks like they're back to the 20. I mean, we didn't hear anything from the referee, Terry Layton. Whatever it is, it's a 5 yard penalty because Idaho is kicking off from the 25 now. It is a re-kick. And that was Colorado State's option, by the way, to make a re-kick. Where the penalty is, it's Mosier and Morton back to receive the kickoff from Trey Farquhar. Mosier takes it this time from the 9. Mosier brought down at the 31. Rams first possession of the second half. What do you expect to see offensively from Colorado State on this first drive of the third quarter?
Yeah, well, for Colorado State, there's a tendency as a coordinator at times to try to get greedy. Just go back to what's been working for you the entire game, get some decent field position, and then take a shot. I think they're going to try to pound the football until they get north of the 50 here, try to set up some good field position and run behind that big offensive line.
Big hole up the middle for Leonard Mason, who picks up 8 on the first carry of the second half. Mason, the junior running back, we mentioned, had the huge game at Colorado. That win at Colorado in Boulder to open the year up for Colorado State. 107 rush yards in that game. Second down and 2. Let's see what Greg Peterson has in his hip pocket. Second and short. Back to the ground out of the Wildcat formation. This is Mosier. On the direct snap, picking up the first down, and Moore with a 10-yard gain to the 48.
Yeah, John Mosier gives you a lot of flexibility lining up in the Wildcat formation. In 2005, he led. He comes out of the state of Florida, Dade County, and Broward County. Now, I'm not going to have a discussion here about hanging chads, but that's a pretty good hotbed for recruiting. And he led that county in rushing in 2005.
That was
John Mosier.
That was one of the things that Coach Fairchild talked about last year, his first year in Colorado. Said, you know, man, I've been out of the recruiting game for a while. Looking at these Florida athletes, I'm blown away with what these 18-year-olds look like. Mosier's out of Columbus High School in Miami, but Fairchild just looking at the tapes and eyeballing some of those players coming out of South Florida, he was really impressed.
It's ridiculous. St. Thomas Aquinas, I call it arguably the number one high school football program in the entire United States of America. This is a college team. They have 13 or 14 guys that will go Division I. Unbelievable high school team, but that area of the country just produces phenomenal athletes, and most schools around the country are trying to get their share.
Play fake on second down and 8. It's an end around. Luke Greenwood takes it. Puts the shoulder pads down. He's dropped after a pickup of 3. Aaron Laverius chases him down.
Colorado State trying to get the linebackers out of position, but it was great execution by the Vandal defense, staying at home, bringing down Greenwood, setting up a 3rd and 5 here. Great opportunity for Idaho, their defense, to get off the field and give their offense an opportunity to go back down the field and put some more points on the board.
3rd down and 5. Stucker, time to throw over the middle, complete. Greer paid the price as he took a big hit from Keo and Robinson converging, but he makes the grab. 1st down, Colorado State.
Yeah, and that's just great protection up front by the Colorado State offensive line. Grant Stucker has all day to throw the football, and Rayshon Greer just finds grass. Greg Peterson, the offensive coordinator, that's what we're hearing talk about. Find a piece of grass, sit down, let the quarterback find you. Great execution, big execution. Big play for Colorado State, moving the sticks.
Out of the eye on 1st down. Long drop for Stucker. dumps it underneath. Mason catches it. It is incomplete. Incomplete. The head linesman immediately signaling incomplete. It's not a catch and a fumble.
Yeah, Mason came across the middle. It appeared to be a catch, but he never secured the football. Gets hit from the blind side.
Robert
C of E jars the football, but he never secured it, setting up a second down for the Rams.
Screen. Incomplete. That was nearly intercepted. Idaho was all over the screen to Mason. C of E again.
Carter, the Vandal defense has now seen that same screenplay about five times. You probably won't see Colorado State run that again because Ciavi recognized that so early. Colorado State is very lucky. That's not a pick six going the other direction.
Eighth play of the Colorado State drive is third down and 10. Rams only 4 for 9 on third down tonight. Stucker steps up, throws. It is incomplete behind Morton. And the Vandal defense comes up with a big stop on third down.
One of the few times tonight that Idaho has been able to provide or apply any pressure at all to Grant Stucker. And while they didn't get to him, they disrupted his timing just a little bit, which caused him to throw an errant pass here. It's going to set up a long field goal, 50-yard attempt here now for Colorado State.
Bend the line, sophomore, career long is 45. This is a 50-yard attempt. Missed it to the right. Enough leg, but he missed it to the right. Not only does Idaho get a stop, they'll get the football near the 40-yard line. Rob Akey's Vandals come charging out of the locker room at the start of the second half. A touchdown on the first offensive possession. They hold Colorado State scoreless, a missed 50-yard field goal. And so now the Vandals will get the football with a chance to tie or take their first lead of the game.
Yeah, more importantly, though, the momentum is back on their side, and they have a lot of confidence offensively. That first drive they came out, went to the short passing game to both Greenwood and Comar, executed, put points on the board, look for them to go back to that on this drive.
Rams show pressure, then back off. Enderle in the intermediate passing game. Max Comar once again behind the linebackers in front of the secondary.
Yep, and they're stomping the puddle dry on that play right now. If Colorado State wants to stop that, they got to do one or two things. They got to get pressure on him with their front four, or they're going to have to tighten up their coverage and quit playing the two deep zone, the soft safety. The problem with that, though, Carter, is Eric Greenwood, Max Comar, when they have gotten one-on-one coverage against the defensive backs for the Rams, they've beaten that coverage.
Blitz coming. Enderle unloads. Comar again, his 10th catch of the night. Now 120 receiving yards. Those are both career highs for the senior from Auburn, Washington. Vandals continue to stomp the puddle.
The other thing, Carter, is look at the production after they come out in the no huddle. A little bit of pace and rhythm now to the offense. Before, in the first half, they were huddling. The game got bogged down. Colorado State was running the football. Crowd got pulled out of it. Now, Idaho's driving, only down by three, had a successful first drive here in the second half, and they found something they can go to there, working Comar and Greenwood in front of the safeties on top of the back.
That was the first rushing play of the second half for Idaho. Third down and 5. Enderle to the air, complete, short of the first down. Off and ear makes a great open field tackle on Preston Davis to force fourth down.
Nick Oppenheimer, the right cornerback for Colorado State, recognizes that, just drives on the football. Great open field tackle, holding him short of the sticks. Fourth down here.
Vandal offense stays on the field.
Yep. Steve Axman, the offensive coordinator, going to go for it here on fourth down.
Woolridge is the back. Idaho has only rushed the football once in this third quarter. On fourth and inches, Woolridge bobbles it, gets it back, and picks up the first down to the 35.
It pays to have a running back that weighs 241 pounds in short yardage situations. Demondre Woolridge at 5'9", 241, 7-yard average per carry. Just rips it up into the line of scrimmage, presses the hole, and picks up the first down.
More of a 7-10 split. Enderly pressured from behind, so he'll tuck it. He'll scramble, and he'll slide, picking up 7 yards on the first down scramble. Log on to Facebook today, search ESPNU, and become a fan. Post your best tailgating photos and comments. We may use them on Inside the Polls Monday, 6 o'clock. On ESPNU HD. After the first down scramble, a fumble on the exchange from Irvin Stevens to Nathan Enderle. Vandals recover.
Yep, one of the few mistakes that we've seen from Idaho in the last 3 drives. And Enderle right there just pulls out early, and the center actually stepped on his foot, which is what caused the fumble. Costly play, because basically at 2nd and 4, that was a throwaway play. Wouldn't surprise me if they took a shot in the end zone. Now at 3rd down, you got to worry about the conversion.
Vandals 4 for 8 on 3rd down. Drew the flag. Boy, that's a heavy play by Enderle.
Offside. Number 66 of the defense, 5-yard penalty. Penalty yardage results in a first down.
Guy Miller, the defensive lineman for Colorado State, second time tonight that he's been flagged on a 3rd and short for offsides, which led to a conversion there for Idaho. Enderle's doing a good job of coming up to the line of scrimmage and drawing Colorado State offsides.
8th play of the drive from just inside the 25. To the end zone on 1st down. Komar makes the grab. Touchdown, Idaho. Vandals take their first lead of the night.
There's good protection up front. Nate Enderle recognizes that Komar comes open. Down the seam on top of the corner, another coverage breakdown for Colorado State. Another huge play for Idaho.
Komar's assessed a penalty for celebration in the end zone. 15 yards enforced on the kickoff.
There is no foul in the play.
And you know what? Let's praise the officiating crew.
Pick it up.
Yeah, Terry Layton and his team conferred. Now, the rule is supposed to be if you celebrate with your teammates, it's fine. You call attention to yourself. That time, Komar was pointing to the stands.
Yep.
I think it saying, hey, great job, fans. He was into it. And that's a good piece of officiating by Terry Layton and his crew to pick up that flag.
Absolutely. And if you saw the Georgia-LSU game, mm-hmm. which, by the way, you departed, so you didn't see all this.
But I had a beautiful drive.
You did have a beautiful drive. But there were two key penalties on excessive celebration. That call by the official nationally right now needs to be looked at, I think.
Now Vandals get to celebrate on the sideline all they want. They have the lead. You're watching ESPNU's College Football Primetime presented by Citi at the Kibbie Dome. At the University of Idaho, Carter Blackburn alongside former Ohio State Buckeye, John Berger.
Unbelievable performance, great execution by the Vandals coming out in the second half. And you look at Greenwood and Komar combined production from the wide receiver position, 243 yards. And that's been the difference. Right now, Colorado State has to answer defensively.
All three touchdowns for Idaho come from those two men, from the arm of Nathan Edwards. Big play in special teams here. Lou Greenwood, they have gotten the football to Greenwood in creative ways tonight. This time, kick return to the 36.
Yep, it's a big play, special teams. Great field position. It's going to be interesting to see how Greg Peterson, the offensive coordinator, calls this series, because Idaho has locked on to the Ram offense, the screen game, the misdirection. It'll be interesting to see how much he trusts Stucker to get the ball downfield on the deep routes to Morton and Rayshon Greer.
Play fake to Mason on first down. Stucker is going to keep it for a short gain. A battle of two 3-1 football teams who just a couple of years ago were mired in long losing streaks. Idaho had an 11-game losing streak. Colorado State had a 13-game losing streak. The Rams, however, wrapped up 2008 with a bowl win, a New Mexico bowl win over Fresno State. They've won six of their last seven. Idaho has outscored Colorado State 14-0 to begin the third quarter, which makes this a critical third down.
Yeah, big time play, third down and seven, another down and distance that's not favorable for Colorado State. Idaho right now is just pinning their ears back defensively and coming downhill at Colorado State. Big play defensively here, big opportunity for the Vandal defense.
Third and six. Stucker pressured, throws, caught, first down. Deion Morton hauls it in with Aaron Grimes draped all over him.
When Grant Stucker has time to throw the football, every time we have seen him have time to throw the football in rhythm and step up into that throw, he delivers an accurate ball. He's got a strong arm, finds Deion Morton over the middle for the big conversion for the Rams.
Flag, too many men breaking the huddle.
Infraction, 12 men in the huddle. Since the offense, 5 yard.
Down at 15. Rear top of the screen, Morton bottom of the screen. Grant Stucker out of the shotgun. Gives it to Mason on the draw. Mason picks up 10 on the first down carry.
Got a big chunk of that yardage back. Like the call by Greg Peterson, the offensive coordinator. First time that Colorado State has run that play all night. The backside inside draw to Leonard Mason. It confused the linebackers, froze them there for a second. Now, instead of a second and a mile, you're in a second, very manageable down and distance.
Colorado State runs the old Washington Redskins style pro set offense. You don't see that a lot in college football anymore in the age of the spread. Mason running straight ahead for a Ram first down inside the Idaho 30.
One of the ways that Colorado State can neutralize the trouble that their defense is having stopping Idaho is to go on a long sustained drive, chew up some clock, put points on the board, and you do that behind your big offensive line. And right now they're executing up front at the point of attack.
Offset eye backfield on first and 10. Motion to the tight end, Heights. Stucker hands off to Leonard Mason. Forced outside where the Vandals chase him down.
cutter that time, JoJo Dixon, the linebacker. Whenever the Vandals see a run play based on their reads, their linebackers this half have made it adjustments. They are just getting north and south into the backfield and try to turn that run play inside so the pursuit from the defense can get at the ball carrier. You saw it again there, well executed play by the defense.
Second down and 8. Mason again, this time running left. This time he is dropped by Kenneth Patton, the cornerback coming up to make the stop.
You see what I'm saying? Kenneth Patton, the corner position, they went in and made the adjustments. And Mark Kreiner, the defensive coordinator, has told their defense, turn that play back inside. And Kenneth Patton comes up from his corner position. And even if he doesn't make that tackle, there's four other guys there that are prepared to bring that ball carry down. Brings up another third and long here for Colorado State.
This will be 3rd and 9. The Rams are 5 for 11 on third down tonight. They converted the last one. On 3rd and 9, pass batted away from Rayshon Greer. Isaac Butts knocked it away. And the Vandal defense holds.
Rayshon Greer is just working down the seam, and Isaac Butts just elevates and bats that football away. That was great defense, inside-out defense. Idaho brought pressure that time, and Stucker had to get rid of the football earlier than he wanted to.
43-yard field goal attempt coming from Ben DeLine. He got it. DeLine missed a 51-yarder last time. That 43-yarder is good. Back to a one-point game. Oh, knows if we're headed for a big finish here. One-point game in the third. Tell you what, though. Monday evening, you can catch two college football shows beginning at 5 Eastern. Crunch Time delivering the entire closing moments, all the exciting college football contests from the previous weekend. Then at 6 Eastern, host Lowell Galindo, analysts Tom Luganville and Tommy Tuberville dissect and analyze the new polls, preview the next week's matchups on Inside the Polls, presented by 76. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. Only one team in the top 10 losing this week. That was Oklahoma. However, Houston going down. Former Washington
you
State
called
head
it.
Coach.
I got to give you credit. Yeah. We had a conversation earlier today. I bought into Houston, lock, stock, and barrel, but spent some time covering that conference, and you called it. I'll give you credit.
Impressive wins, obviously, by the Cougars back-to-back weeks against Big 12 opponents, but the defense was a question mark, and they were exposed. I think at last count, UTEP had 58 points in that game. So I think the question mark for the Houston defense was an exclamation mark tonight for UTEP. Here in Moscow, Idaho, at a sold-out Kibbie Dome. It's a one-point Idaho lead. After Ben DeLine's field goal, this kick is fielded by Jones, who brings it back out to the 37. Good field position for the Vandals. It was 20-10 at the half, Colorado State, and now 14-3. That field goal by DeLine ended the run of 14 unanswered points by Idaho.
Give Idaho credit going in to halftime, making the adjustments, and I really think the difference, Carter, is offensively coming out two things. They went to the no huddle, which sped things up. It kept the same defense on the field from Colorado State, and they just continue to work Komar and Greenwood on top of the linebackers in front of the safeties, having a lot of success with that intermediate pass play. And right now, Colorado State just doesn't have an answer for that.
Vandals have touchdown drives on the first two possessions of the third quarter. Enderle gets away from the pressure, scrambles and slides to the 45. Sisson nearly had him in the backfield once Enderle got past him, room to run.
Yeah, that time, Colorado State, recognizing what's going on, they bring pressure with Sisson, and he almost gets there. Nate Enderle does a nice job of avoiding that and just picking up positive yards here, setting up a second short here for the Vandals.
Call it second down and 3. Enderle to the air. This is Greenwood, who makes a great grab inside the 35. The career night continues for Eric Greenwood.
Another isolated instance. Enderle looks up, recognizes there's one-on-one coverage with Eric Greenwood against Elijah Blue Smith. Great execution, accurate ball, another first down for Idaho.
Enderle to the air again, short for Komar as he was pressured by D'Angelo Wilkinson, coming on the corner blitz as the Rams now start to mix up their defensive coverages.
Colorado State right now is just getting gashed by the pass game from Idaho. And Larry Kerr, the defensive coordinator, is going to have to dial up some pressure here, maybe a zone blitz, bring in a defensive back, bring in Sisson from the linebacker position, because they've got to get Nate Enderle on the ground or at least disrupt his timing.
He was WAC Player of the Week on a 270-yard passing day last week in Northern Illinois. Enderle may be going for back-to-back Conference Player of the Week. Pass incomplete. Komar hits the ground, and here's a late flag on Michael Sisson. Komar comes up awkwardly.
Pass interference, number 6 of the defense. This is a spot foul and results in a first down.
Spot foul because it's less than 15 yards.
Sisson just gets there a bit early. Komar just takes a shot in his ribcage there. And he'll shake that off. The kind of night he's having, I don't think you could drag him off the field.
With Deontay Jackson behind him. Only 2 rushing plays in this half for Idaho. Enderle to the air again. Complete again. Why run the football when you can pick apart the Colorado State secondary, as Nathan Enderle's doing again? This time it's Preston Davis.
Yeah, Idaho is just going up against that zone. Their wideouts are just finding grass. They're just finding space. Enderle has all day to throw the football, because there's just no pressure up front. And when a quarterback as good as Enderle has that much time, he's going to complete that ball every time.
First and goal from the 10. Enderle over the middle. Komar makes the grab, short of the goal line. But it's a gain of about 7 before Chris Gibson makes a stop on Komar, who continues his career night.
Komar is manned up against the linebacker, Michael Sisson, coming out of the slot inside of the red zone. When you're covering a slot receiver inside the red zone, it's important that you don't let him cross your face. And Komar just gets the inside position. Enderle delivers an accurate ball. Big gain, or another big play there for the Vandals.
Last play of the third quarter, if they can get it off. They do not. That is the end of the third quarter. A third quarter that belonged to the Idaho Vandals. A pair of touchdown drives, 3 touchdown passes in the game. Outscoring Colorado State in the third. A 1-point Vandal lead as we head to the fourth. You're watching ESPNU's College Football Primetime, presented by Citi at the Kibbie Dome. The campus of the University of Idaho. Carter Blackburn with John Berger. Start of the fourth quarter. This will be second down and goal for Idaho. Enderle, toss weak. Woolridge hit at the goal line and driven back. What a play by Chris Gibson.
Yeah, Gibson, the linebacker from Colorado State, meets Woolridge in the hole. Not an easy thing to do as a linebacker holding a 241-pound running back coming downhill at you. Great open field tackle by Gibson, keeping him out of the end zone, setting up a third and goal for the Vandals.
Rams fans love it. Third down and goal. Woolridge gets it again. And gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Idaho. Three possessions in the second half. three touchdowns.
Key third down play, and they go over the left side behind the senior, Mikey Upati. Devondre Rulbridge is sticking it in the end zone. Three drives, three touchdowns for Idaho. Outstanding adjustments at halftime and great play calling by Steve Axman, the offensive coordinator. This offense is dialed in right now.
Trey Farquhar for the PAT. Vandals trail by 10 at the half. They lead by 8, just 29 seconds into the fourth quarter. Remember Dan and Dave? Well, they certainly remember Dan around the University of Idaho as we check out our ESPNU campus connection. Dan O'Brien, 1996 Olympic decathlete, gold medal winner, graduated from Idaho in 93, trained under Idaho track and field coach Mike Keller. He was inducted into the inaugural Idaho Hall of Fame class in 2007. University's track and field venue named after him. Now lives in the Phoenix area. He's a volunteer track coach at Arizona State. Remember the old Versace ads?
I do. Do you remember Michael Johnson's gold shoes that year?
No, of course.
That was awesome. Did you go to the Olympics?
No, I didn't. Great
experience. Put it on the list.
Sure.
Anytime you get an opportunity to go see an Olympic game.
Let me tell you, I'll go to Rio de Janeiro anytime, but I'll definitely go there for the Olympics if I'm invited. So three possessions in the second half for the Idaho offense. Two of them were touchdown passes from Nathan Enderle and now Demondre Woolridge into the end zone for the sixth time in 2009. Morton bobbles the kickoff, recovers, and then sprints down the far sideline. Great recovery from Deion Morton. Last Colorado State drive ended in a 43-yard field goal from Ben DeLine. But only 3 points from the Ram offense in the second half.
Yeah, it's going to be up to Greg Peterson and that big offensive line for Colorado State. Key drive. They need to put points on the board. Right now, Idaho, all the momentum on their side with all the adjustments. Three drives, three touchdowns for them. It's time for Colorado State. They need to respond and mount a sustained drive here and put points on the board.
Play fake on first down. Grant Stucker over the middle, caught. Greer on the post. Makes the grab at the 45. Jones brings him down.
It's interesting to see how this game has played out, because when Stucker has time to throw the football, man, he has been on the money all night, throwing the ball downfield to Morton and Rayshon Greer. If they give him enough time, he can hit that big play in the pass game.
Mosier gets it in the Wildcat on first down, picking his way around the left side. Height seals the edge. Mosier picks up 6.
Third time we've seen the Wildcat with John Mosier. They go off the left side behind their all-conference offensive line, Shelly Smith and Tim Waltler. They get moving up front, and that's just a play where they're telling Mosier, find a crease and get north and south. And that's what Greg Peterson likes most about his running back from Miami.
Stucker back under center on second down and short. Mason is the back. Late fake to Mason. A dragging Greer makes the grab, and he has room to run. Makes the first man miss. Second man is Keo, and he brings Greer down. But a big gain on second down and short.
Yep, that's the third time we've seen that same play. It's coming from a different direction. They go play action, which basically freezes the linebackers, and you're going to see Rayshon Greer come all the way across on the backside. Nobody is within 10 yards of him. And he just gets up the sideline, moves the sticks, picks up a big first down for Colorado State.
18-yard pickup. Leonard Mason wrapped up and dropped. Brandon Arts makes the stop.
Yeah, Arts comes up. When they look at that at film on Monday, they're going to have a conversation with Mason. He had to stay north and south. Puts a little wiggle. He makes one guy miss right there. He's sitting in the end zone.
Second and nine. Stucker gets max protection, flings it to Tyson Leggett. Near another first down before Kenneth Patton makes a stop.
Deion Morton, with all the success that he's had, basically just runs off the defensive backs for the Vandals, and Leggett just comes underneath because they have so much respect for that deep play, and because Morton has had a big night catching the football. Love the play call by Greg Peterson, the offensive coordinator. Yet another first down for Colorado State.
Last time deep in Vandal territory, the drive stalled out. Field goal attempt. Mosier will take the direct snap. Mosier, tough running for another 7 yards on first down.
Talked about the play of Colorado State's offensive line, and this is usually the point in the game that they can start wearing you down. Now, keep in mind, they've got four guys that'll probably play in the NFL, all north of 300 pounds. Not a big deal in the first quarter, but over four quarters of play, this is where a defense can start wearing down, and we've seen that from two successive Wildcat plays with John Mosier in the backfield.
Stucker takes it from the shotgun, takes it himself on the QB draw, may have been pushed back. Aaron Laverius indeed makes a stop on Stucker short of the first down.
Yeah, that was a designed quarterback draw by Grant Stucker. Second time that they've run it tonight. Gets up close to the first down, but they're going to be just a little short, setting up the third and short for the Rams.
Colorado State only 5 for 12 on third down tonight. This is third and one. Offset eye backfield. Play fake to Mason. Pass is bobbled and incomplete on third down and short. Intended for the tight end, Eric Pites.
Stucker has time, and Pites just settles, finds a spot, and that's he just drops the football. Stucker delivered a ball that was catchable. Pites just takes his eyes off it, bobbles the ball. Interestingly enough here, that Greg Peterson going for it here on fourth down with 10 minutes left in the fourth.
Morton motions. Fourth and one. Mason gets the handoff and appears to get the first down.
Part of the side judge came in from the looks of where he came in. It looks like they've executed and going to get a fresh set of downs here.
Measurement coming. This should be close. Vandal football.
Wow. What a defensive stand by Idaho.
And how about a Ram offense that has been able to ram the football down the middle of that Idaho defense most of the night, not being able to pick up a yard on fourth down.
Yep, and give credit to the defense inside the red zone. The last couple of drives for Colorado State, the Idaho defense have stepped up with key stops. Now up by eight with 10 minutes left, Idaho takes over on downs.
Three times the Idaho offense has taking the football in the second half. Three touchdown drives. Handing off on first down. It's Woolridge. Breaks through to the second level for a gain of 7.
Talked early about all the talent that the Vandals have at the running back position with Deontay Jackson, with Princeton McCarty. Don't be surprised if they use DeMondre Woolridge here to close out the ball game. Try to feed him the ball. He's going to give you 4 to 5 yards a carry and try to get out of here with a win.
Rams show pressure from Sisson and Gibson. Woolridge gets it again on second down. Leaning forward for an Idaho first down. Move the chains. ESPNU kicks 2 women's college soccer games on Sunday. First at 3 Eastern, LSU taking on Auburn. Then at 5 Eastern in the Big 12, Missouri versus Texas A&M. Women's college soccer on ESPNU Sunday. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. Carter Blackburn with John Berger, our ESPNU crew from the Kibbie Dome in Moscow, Idaho, where the Vandals are attempting to run the football, run the clock with an 8-point lead. The Vandals are 3-1 for the first time in 15 years. 15 years ago, they went to 4-1 on the way to a 9-win season. We talked about, you know, the Vandals' recent struggles, but this was a program that had great success at the 1AA level, perennial playoff team. Their second year of 1A, they went to the Humanitarian Bowl and beat Southern Miss. Second and 2 here for the Vandals. Trying to run it again. This time it's McCarty, and he is tripped up for a loss, bringing up third down. How about Enderley in the second half? 11 of 13 for 174 yards. A pair of touchdown passes in the second half.
Yep.
And on third down and 4, you would think Enderley maybe passes for the first time on this drive. Quick drop, quick throw. It's caught. First down. Greenwood hauls it in. Forward progress marks him down at the 35.
Colorado State went with a zone blitz that time, trying to get some pressure on Enderley, and he finds his big man, the 6'6 wide receiver, Eric Greenwood. Critical, critical conversion for Idaho. Now 7:35 left in the ball game, up by 8, and right now they have the ability to burn a lot of clock here in the fourth quarter.
Greenwood now 6 catches, 130 yards, both career highs. First and 10, toss sweep. Woolridge picking his way to the 40. Running right over Clint Kubiak, the strong safety.
Yeah, at this point in the ball game with 7:13 left, Idaho has asserted themselves up front at the line of scrimmage. Colorado State's going to have to take some risk. You're getting into the zone there where, you know, with clock running right now, Idaho having success running the football. Don't be surprised if Colorado State tries to dial up a blitz here to get their defense off the field.
This is second down and 5. No blitz coming, so Woolridge able to spin out of a tackle into Ram territory. First down. Sisson laid a glove on Woolridge, but he just spun right out for a Vandal first down.
Yeah, DeMondre Woolridge at 241 pounds. He's the guy that they want to close out this game. The senior out of Keller, Texas, showing a lot of patience and gets north and south quickly. And that's what Steve Axman, the offensive coordinator, loves about him, is I can use him to close out a ball game. 12 rushes, 43 yards, 4-yard average. But a lot of that has come here in the fourth quarter.
Woolridge spent 05 and 06 down the road at Washington State when Rob Akey was there, and then came with Akey over to Idaho. Woolridge had the breakthrough game last week at Northern Illinois with 143 rushing yards. He won't come close to those numbers tonight, But this performance on this drive, just as critical.
Yep, absolutely. It's not the body of work in terms of sheer numbers, but if you look at what he brings to the offense, the ability to control the clock, the ability to keep the chains moving, and then when they want to bring in a Deontay Jackson or Princeton McCarty, they're a little more of the flash, a little more of the spark. But right now, Idaho's just trying to burn clock here with a comfortable lead. 5:28 left here in the fourth.
On the reverse, Bailey is wrapped up and dropped. After the accelerator was pressed down for Idaho, you just throw in reverse.
Idaho having plenty of success running right at the Colorado State defense. And second long there, they go with reverse. Colorado State's having none of it. They stay at home, and now it's setting up a third and long here, which gives Colorado State the opportunity to make a stop and get the football back.
This is third and eight. Pressure coming up the middle from the Rams, so Enderle will audible. Play clock winding down. 1 second to get it off. He does. Here's the pressure. Enderle sacked. There comes the blitz at long last, and Clint Kubiak gets to Nate Enderle.
Colorado State, for whatever reason, has waited till deep here in the fourth to bring that pressure. Kubiak coming from the safety position. They dial up the blitz. They get to Enderle. Going to force a punt here in Colorado State now with 3:58 left. All three timeouts down by eight. He's going to have an opportunity here to execute.
10-play drive over 6 minutes, but no points out of it for Idaho. Cowan's kick, fair catch called for. Morton will grab it at the 11. So 3 minutes, 40 seconds to go. Can Grant Stucker rally the Rams in Moscow? ESPNU College Football Primetime is presented by Citi. Citi never sleeps. Down to the air for Greer. He makes the grab. Flag on the play. Greer gave a little push.
Pass interference. Number two of the defense. This penalty is declined. First down.
Rams take the completion. Colorado State has only 3 points in the second half. They trail by eight, meaning you would need a touchdown, a two-point conversion in the last 3 minutes, 30 seconds of the ball game.
Yep, clock management right now, important for Colorado State. Plenty of time with 3:25, but they need to continue to move the sticks.
Stucker gives it to Mosier. 3 yard pickup on first down.
For the most part, Colorado State inside the 20s, 20 to 20, they've had a good offensive game plan. They've executed pretty well. It's just in this half, they bogged down inside the red zone.
Had a missed 50-yard attempt from the line. A made 43-yard field goal from the line. And then the fourth down stop by Idaho on the last Colorado State possession. Stucker to the air on second down. Nice grab by Lou Greenwood, who is showing up tonight.
They get the matchup that they want. Lou Greenwood is isolated on a linebacker, number 34, JoJo Dixon. Stucker delivers an accurate ball, and Greenwood makes a great grab there, giving Colorado State that another first down on a critical drive here for the Rams.
Play fake on first down, the screen to Greer. Right up the middle of the Idaho State defense on the screen before Jeremy Jones brings Greer down. Inside the 40 now.
Yeah, I like the play call by offensive coordinator Brett Peterson there, and they bring Rayshon Greer inside on the wide receiver screen. Two consecutive back-to-back big plays by Colorado State on this drive.
126 receiving yards for Greer in a big bounce back game. Stucker on first down, completing again. Greenwood slips out of a tackle. Lou Greenwood slips out of another tackle and takes it to the end zone. Touchdown, Colorado State. The true freshman makes the grab, breaks two tackles, and rolls 39 yards for the score.
Lou Greenwood, the freshman, makes a huge play for Colorado State, not only making the catch, but then making three Idaho defenders miss him in space, taking it into the end zone now.
Two-point conversion upcoming for Colorado State. Rams going for the tie. It's Mosier lined up for the direct snap. Mosier leans. Did he get in? He did not. Idaho holds again. The Vandals hang on to the lead with a two-point conversion stop. So the booth will take another look at this, but from that replay we just showed you, Mosier is stopped short of the goal line, no doubt about it. And then the call is unsportsmanlike conduct on the offense enforced on the kickoff.
Yeah, not only is Colorado State not going to get the touchdown, John Mosier is clearly down about a half a yard short of the goal line. But now Idaho is going to get the ball plus 15 yards coming out. That was a huge, huge hit by Shiloh Keo, number 10, the safety for Idaho. It appears right there that Mosier's going to get in, and then Keo from the safety position, recognizing that play early, just comes in, delivers a shot to Mosier, keeping him out of the end zone.
And give it up for the free safety Shiloh Keo and the strong side linebacker JoJo Dixon. Two of those juniors who played a lot as true freshmen when they weren't winning any football games.
JoJo Dixon.
Review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. The extra point is no good.
I don't know if you saw, Carter, but JoJo Dixon, the linebacker, number 34, took on Shelly Smith, the pulling guard. You got a 229-pound linebacker going up against a 300-pound offensive lineman. Takes out Shelly Smith, and then his buddy Shiloh Keo comes across and drops Mosier short of the goal line.
Vandals get the football, trying to close out the win over Colorado State. Crowd at the Kibbie Dome in Moscow, Idaho, has seen their Vandals come storming back from a 10-point deficit at the half to a 2-point lead with just a minute 41 left in the fourth quarter. Colorado State gets to the end zone, but the 2-point conversion comes up a yard shy. Now the Rams will kick off, and you have to think onside kick coming from Ben DeLine.
Yeah, Ben DeLine's going to line up on the right hash, drive the football into the ground. He's just trying to get a second hop bounce and try to get the football up in the air, try to get it batting around, knocking around off a few of the players. Colorado, they trying to get Colorado State down there, but Idaho got a good set of hands players, including Max Gomar, which has had his hands on the football all night long.
And remember, this is kicked off from the 45 because of a personal foul against Colorado State after the touchdown. The line for the onside kick. It is caught by Keo. So give Keo another big play today. 11 tackles, the stop on the two-point conversion, and the junior leader of the Vandal defense comes up with the onside kick recovery. So now the Vandal offense gets the football, trying to run the football, run the clock, and go to 4-1. You're watching ESPNU's College Football Primetime presented by Citi at the Kibbie Dome on the campus of the University of Idaho. Carter Blackburn with Ohio State Buckeye alumnus John Berger. Idaho gets a football, two-point lead, a minute 40 remaining. Trying to run the football and run the clock. Woolridge gets it started on a positive note, picking up 5 on first down. Colorado State uses the first of its 3 timeouts. Semantics here, but let's go back to why Colorado State was kicking off from the 45 there.
Yeah, the official on the previous drive on the two-point conversion where John Mosier lined up in the Wildcat formation, Idaho stopped him just short, but the official came out and indicated it was a penalty on the offense, which would have backed Colorado State up, but apparently it was just a botched call in terms of how he communicated that.
So
it was actually against the defense, which moved the kicking position up to the 45.
It was going to be an onside kick anyway, just backing Idaho up just a little bit. So, the sold-out Kibbie Dome, ready to celebrate an Idaho win. A program who had only 3 victories in the past 2 seasons is a minute 34 away from going to 4-1.
Not only that, Carter, but if you look at their schedule, sitting at 4-1, they go at San Jose State. They get Hawaii at home, at Nevada, La Tech at home, Fresno at home. They could quite possibly be 9-1 going to Boise. Ooh. Think about that for a second. 2-10 to 9-1 going to Boise, that is.
Last bowl game was in 1998, they won the Humanitarian Bowl. Rob Akey, when he fed his team those grilled steaks at the first meeting of their fall camp, he served it to them in bowls. No plates around.
You think that was the secret, huh?
Because he says, I want my guys thinking about a bowl from the very first get-go. And 4 wins now, if they can close out this one tonight. Obviously, you need 6 to become bowl eligible. And as you said, through the WAC, there's obviously some tests there, but you have Hawaii, Louisiana Tech, Fresno State all at home here in the Kibbie Dome.
Yeah, not only that, but Hawaii lost their quarterback, Greg Alexander. He's out for the year. Nevada, I think, based on watching them on film, I think Idaho can play with that team. The pistol offense is a little different. You're going to have to prepare for it differently. But La Tech, Fresno State, right now, surprising me. They're struggling more than I thought they would. Idaho, to me, is a very balanced team in the sense that they can attack you with multiple weapons. And we saw that tonight with Woolridge. We saw it with Deontay Jackson. And when you give Enterly time to throw the football, he's as good as anybody in college football.
3rd and 4, Enterly to the air. Incomplete. Greenwood nearly hung on, but Nick Offenier knocks it away. And a big 3rd down stop for the Rams. So 4th down here. Great play by Offenier.
Yeah, it really was. They got the matchup they wanted, and Offenier just comes over the top and just bats the football away.
Allen's average 46 yards punting. He'll hit this one right around the 40. Morton to return it for Colorado State. They set up the return. Bounces, and it's a touchback. Let's look at the Rams' upcoming schedule. They have Utah at home at TCU, San Diego State at home, Air Force at home, and then at UNLV and at New Mexico. Tough 2 weeks coming up for Colorado State with Utah at home and then at TCU.
Yep, Utah, big loss for Matt Asiata, the running back. That really changes things in my mind. And going down to Fort Worth is always a difficult place to play as well.
Rams hoping for a game-winning drive with a minute 14 to go. Stucker, long drop on first down. Pass is intercepted. It's Shiloh Keo who picks it off for Idaho. The junior leader of the Vandals defense. He missed almost all of his sophomore season. Back as a junior with the biggest defensive play that Idaho football has seen in a long, long time.
Shiloh Keo recognizes that early in its development. He's seen it all night. He jumps the route, secures the football, and then gets down. What a huge night for Keo.
11 tackles, including the stand at the goal line on the two-point conversion, and now the INT to all but seal it for Idaho. Rams have only one timeout. Well, a minute three away from that 4-1 mark for Idaho in 1994 when they went on to win 9 games. That was back in the 1AA days. This will be the first 4-1 start of the 1A or the FBS football bowl subdivision. Idaho went 1A in 1996. Talked about their recent struggles, but again, great football tradition. This is where Jerry Kramer played. Mark Schlereth, John Freeze, and coaches like Tom Cable, John L. Smith, Dennis Erickson. Rob Akey is drawing praise from all around the country for this coaching effort. I mean, your first head coaching job, you win 3 games the first 2 years, but he laid the foundation, turning over the entire roster, bringing in a lot of young players, playing them early on, going through the lumps. And now he goes over to the student section to thank them for their efforts tonight. You gotta love it.
Yep. Do you think he brings a little bit spark to this university and to this football team? And just talking to him, Carter, he's one of those guys that when you sit down with him, your energy level, if it's at a 6, is going to a 10.
False start, number 77. Offense, 5-yard penalty, 2nd down.
How about Nate Enderle in the second half? 12 of 15 for 179 yards, 2 touchdown passes. He leads a 3rd touchdown drive. And you know that that junior class that was recruited here by Rob Akey, and they had to buy in, and they had to keep buying in. In fact, I asked Shiloh Keo about, all right, you get off to this 3-1 start, does that validate the hard work? He says, we always knew the hard work would pay off. Yep. We never doubted, and now it's paying off. A 4-1 start, Idaho hangs on to win it 31-29 over Colorado State. All around impressive performance for Idaho. You can call it a team win, call this a program win for the Vandals.
Idaho on track. You look at coming into this ball game, what a terrific job they did of adjusting in the second half, doing what they had to do and getting a huge victory here at home.
From 10 down at the half, Idaho comes back to win it 31-29 over Colorado State. For John Berger and our entire ESPNU crew, I'm Carter Blackburn. Coming up next, it's SportsCenter U. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. We are College Sports. Rob Akey's Idaho Vandals go to 4-1 with a 31-29 win over Colorado State. Good night from Moscow, Idaho. We send you to SportsCenter U.